तो पहला सवाल है, ये डीम्ड कन्वेंस और कन्वेंस में क्या फर्क है? डीम्ड कन्वेंस एक कानूनी प्रक्रिया है जिसमें से आपको आपका जमीन का और बिल्डिंग का हस्तांतर किया जाएगा। एक कानूनी प्रक्रिया आपको करना पड़ेगा, नहीं है तो कायदा यही बोलता है कि यू आर ऑल डीम्ड टू हैव रिसीव्ड द कन्वेंस। दिस इज वेरी सिंपल, द सेक्शन 11 ऑफ द महाराष्ट्र ओनरशिप फ्लैट एक्ट सेज विदिन 4 months इफ द बिल्डर डज नॉट गिव यू द कन्वेंस इट इज डीम्ड टू हैव बीन कन्वेड। दैट इज द ओनली डीमिंग फंक्शन, मतलब एक लीगल फिक्शन तैयार किया है, बट उसमें आगे बताया कि इन केस दे डोंट गिव यू अप्लाई टू द कॉम्पिट अथॉरिटी। हु इज द कॉम्पिट अथॉरिटी? डिस्ट्रिक्ट डिप्टी रजिस्ट्रार। आप डिस्ट्रिक्ट डिप्टी रजिस्ट्रार के पास जाइए, एप्लीकेशन डालिए, बिल्डर को और जमीन मालिक को आप रेस्पोंडेंट बना दीजिए। DDR विल कॉल फॉर द इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द रजिस्ट्र, मतलब बिल्डर एंड लैंड ओनर, एंड आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग द हियरिंग, जिसको 6 महीने का मुदत दिया गया, 6 महीने के अंदर उनको जो भी डिसीजन लेना है, एंड वंस ही गिव्स द सर्टिफिकेट ऑर्डर फॉर सेइंग दैट यू आर एंटाइटल्ड फॉर अ कन्वेंस, उसके बाद कन्वेंस डीड बनेगा जिसके ऊपर डिस्ट्रिक्ट डिप्टी रजिस्ट्रार विल साइन ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द लैंड ओनर एंड बिल्डर। ही स्टेप्स इन टू द शूज ऑफ द लैंड ओनर एंड बिल्डर। उसके बाद आपको कन्वेंस का एग्जीक्यूशन होने के बाद उसके ऊपर स्टैम्प ड्यूटी होती है। मान लीजिए आपके पास 100 फ्लैट है, 100 लोगों ने स्टैम्प ड्यूटी भरा है तो सिर्फ 100 रुपये पर फ्लैट स्टैम्प ड्यूटी लिया जाएगा। यदि 98 लोगों ने भरा है तो 2 आदमी जिन्होंने स्टैम्प ड्यूटी भरा नहीं अपना एग्रीमेंट में, दैट विल बी टेकन एट द टाइम ऑफ एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ कन्वेंस डीड। उसके बाद प्रॉपर्टी कार्ड में आपका नाम इनकॉर्पोरेट किया जाएगा बाय अप्लाइंग टू द सिटी सर्वे ऑफिस, एंड लास्ट ऑफकोर्स आप BMC का प्रॉपर्टी टैक्स में भी अपना नाम ला सकते हो। इस तरह का जो पूरा प्रक्रिया जो करना पड़ता है आफ्टर द कन्वेंस, तो इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं डीम्ड कन्वेंस। और मैं इतना ही बोलूँगा, कन्वेंस और डीम्ड कन्वेंस एक ही फर्क है। इन द केस ऑफ ए कन्वेंस वेयर द लैंड ओनर एंड बिल्डर बोथ कम वॉलेंटरली एग्जीक्यूट द एग्रीमेंट ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द सोसाइटी एंड कंप्लीट द फॉर्मेलिटी। इन द केस ऑफ ए डीम्ड कन्वेंस वेयर DDR आफ्टर कंडक्टिंग द हियरिंग स्टेप्स इन टू द शूज ऑफ द लैंड ओनर एंड बिल्डर एंड गिव्स यू द कन्वेंस। So therefore, I am telling you, after exhausting all the available approaches with the developer, and if you think the developers are not cooperating, you have got a system where you can go and get the conveyance. Now the difference between deemed conveyance and regular court conveyance, you can go to the city civil court, which was prevailing before introduction of deemed conveyance. There you have to go to the city civil court where it takes about 10 years, maybe 8 years, 7 years to get the order of the conveyance. Once that order of the conveyance is received, then you have to apply separately for execution. The moment you apply for the execution, again the city civil court hear you, then they will designate their own officer as a registrar to execute the conveyance on the behalf of landowner and builder. Us execution process ko bhi 2-3 saal jata hai. Uske baad you get an appointment of the registrar to execute the conveyance on behalf of landowner and builder. Ye jo 10 saal ka period hai, that is getting reduced by only small provision made in that law, that is it is deemed to have been conveyed, so you don't have to go to the process of going to the city civil court, hearing the party, then get the, you know, arguments, oral argument, written argument, nothing is required. Same thing is with the consumer court. Even in the consumer court you can go. Once you go to the consumer court will pass the order. After passing the order, again for the purpose of execution, you have to again approach city consumer court, and thereafter, again there may be appeal, there may be second appeal. So we don't know. Matter may go up to Supreme Court also. Here in the case of a deemed conveyance, it's a final order, and if you are aggrieved, you can go in the High Court for challenging that under the writ petition, and thereafter, of course, you can go under the special leave petition to the Supreme Court. So in short, deemed conveyance is a bore. But now, last 2 years, let me tell you, from the year 2020, a developers body, with due respect to Builders Association of India, you are aware of CREDAI MCHI, who have made a representation to government, housing department, saying that the deemed conveyance and the MOFA provision need to be repealed. We have been writing to the government, we have been having a series of meetings, saying that please don't repeal MOFA, let MOFA be there. But the contention of the developer is that when there is RERA, Real Estate Regulation and Development Act, why there should be second law MOFA? We said MOFA is an existing law. The RERA allows you to have a local law. And this has been not repealed by the High Court and Supreme Court. Why the government should repeal its own the law which is there for the last 60 years? Unfortunately, there is a lot of lobby that is working out, and believe me, in next 1 year, MOFA will be repealed. Because we have been contesting, we have been going ahead, we have made a series of meetings with the ministers, housing secretaries, everybody. But they are bent upon repealing it. Now, having known this knowledge, we had to work on how to compel the societies to get at least deemed convinced. For that, the government last 2 years have been aggressively working to have drive. But some or the other, the response that we are getting in the drive is very lukewarm, that is very less. Today, out of 60% cooperating society who are not having conveyance, hardly 5 to 10% have gone for the deemed conveyance in the last 13 years. 2010 it has started implemented. In 13 years, hardly 8 to 10,000 societies have got out of 120,000 societies, not even less than 10%. I'm so surprised why societies are not coming forward. Whatever may be the reason, now the government has come out with another directive that every district deputy registrar will conduct the local seminars. They will go ahead and educate the people and see that the conveyance is completed in next 1 year, so that after 1 year, in 2024 or by 2025, definitely MOFA will be repealed. At that time, everybody will start wondering why the government is repealed. So therefore, we as an association have come out with the booklet. Those who want, free of cost, it is available. You can have it. And secondly,